Powerful cosmic rays smash through spaceships. But how can objects smaller than an atom carry enough energy to be dangerous to astronauts?
Moving objects carry energy. We call this kinetic energy. And when they strike something, they transform that energy. When I hit my hand, the kinetic energy of my fist transforms into sound and heat and vibration. My hand hurts a little from that impact, from the transformation of energy.
It's the same thing with cosmic rays. When they slam into a human brain cell or a computer chip, they dump some energy, causing damage. How much damage depends on their kinetic energy, and that comes down to two things: mass and speed.
Intuitively, things that are moving at the same speed, if they're more massive, they carry more energy. A bigger asteroid slamming into Earth will do more damage than a smaller asteroid.
If you double the mass of an object, its kinetic energy also doubles. Although mass is important, it's not as important as speed.
Speed matters even more than mass. The kinetic energy depends directly on the mass, but it depends on the square of the speed. Here's what that means. You double the mass, you have double the kinetic energy. You double the speed, you have four times the kinetic energy.
When it comes to speed, cosmic rays are the elite. An ultra-high energy cosmic ray, detected in 1991, hit the atmosphere so fast, scientists called it the "Oh My God" particle.
This particle was higher energy than they thought they would ever see.
Until this fluorescent streak in the Utah sky, no one believed the particle could reach the Earth, traveling so close to the speed of light, making cosmic ray particles far more dangerous than expected.
As you approach the speed of light, energy, momentum, mass, they start to act a little bit differently.
Einstein's equations of relativity become important. The physics changes, and the energy it has becomes much, much, much stronger.
If a particle is moving at close to the speed of light, that means that its energy is almost at the maximum allowed by the laws of physics.
It's amazing to think that something as tiny as a proton could actually be dangerous to a human being. But amazingly, that proton is moving so fast, it carries as much energy as a baseball thrown at 100 miles an hour.
A baseball contains over a trillion protons. Imagine all that energy carried by just one particle.
So now you get a sense of just how risky these can be.
Ultra-high energy cosmic rays, like the Oh My God particle, are like supersonic missiles. They are the fastest, but they're so rare, astronauts are unlikely to be hit by one. Solar cosmic rays are like BB pellets. Abundant, but our spacecraft can block them. The biggest threat to our astronauts, however, are galactic cosmic rays. They come from elsewhere in the Milky Way. The combination of their speed and frequency makes them the most dangerous.
These galactic cosmic rays are much more powerful than the solar cosmic rays, and they've traveled enormous distances to mess you up.
Luckily, our astronauts have a surprising protector, a guardian of the solar system, the sun.
As well as spitting out these high-energy solar cosmic ray particles, the sun is also streaming out lots of much lower energy particles of the solar wind.
That outward moving solar wind acts as a force field, and the cosmic rays have to work their way upstream to get to Earth, far inside this bubble.
The solar wind extends 11 billion miles around the solar system, generating a magnetic field that repels incoming galactic cosmic rays.
It's almost like the deflector shield of the Starship Enterprise. So the sun's magnetic field partially helps protect the Earth and any astronauts from the incoming radiation.
Not long ago, our Voyager spacecraft made it to that boundary between the sun's bubble and the galaxy and was able to study that region. And we see the difference between inside the sun's bubble and what's going on outside the sun's bubble. The sun has our back billions of miles away, and that's pretty cool.
The Voyager space probes discovered a moving battlefield. The solar wind behaves a bit like a storm front on Earth. Sometimes it advances, sometimes it retreats.
When the sun's activity is the highest, it's spitting out more solar energetic protons. But those solar cosmic rays are much less damaging than the galactic ones. So the net is a benefit.
So actually, ironically, you might find that for astronauts, it is safer to launch missions to Mars during a period of higher solar activity. Because although you have more of the solar particle radiation, you also get a better shielding effect from the solar wind.
The sun's activity goes through an 11-year cycle of highs and lows. The protective bubble follows the same cycle, allowing NASA to predict the safest times to launch.
This is a thorny problem, and you know, we have very smart people working on it, but we want to explore space as much as we can, but we have to lower the risk to the astronauts as much as possible.
NASA's fight against the cosmic invaders continues, but the biggest mystery remains. What exactly is launching the deadliest galactic cosmic rays? Every second, quadrillions of bits of space shrapnel race towards Earth at close to the speed of light. Galactic cosmic rays.
The galactic cosmic rays are like a rifle bullet. You do not want to get hit by one of these.
They are invaders from outside the solar system. We know they're made by something powerful within our galaxy, so the source should be easy to detect.
You'd think if one of them hits a detector on Earth that we'd just be able to point back in a straight line and say it came from over there, and then look, is there something else over there, like a supernova explosion that could explain the source of this? The problem is that cosmic rays get bent as they move by magnetic fields.
The electric charge on a cosmic ray makes it act like a little magnet. And the Milky Way is full of other magnets.
If I'm a cosmic ray just barreling through the galaxy and I encounter a magnetic field, I'm gonna slightly change directions. Maybe here, maybe there, maybe up there. My trajectory is going to become scrambled.
And after a few million years or so, basically all the information about where it started has been lost. It's going in a completely random direction for all practical purposes.
But galactic cosmic rays also have a sidekick. One that is far less elusive, gamma rays.
When a galactic cosmic ray hits a regular atom out in space, it causes this big reaction.
It emits all sorts of other particles, including gamma rays, which are basically extremely energetic photons of light. Critically, gamma rays don't get bent by magnetic fields because they don't have an electric charge. So they just beeline off in a straight line along whatever direction the cosmic ray was moving in the first place.
So we can look back at where gamma rays are coming from in the sky, and that tells us where there are a lot of cosmic rays having collisions.
And they've led us to a prime suspect. Supernovas.
Supernova are some of the most powerful explosions in the universe, and so they're ripe grounds for these highly energetic, extremely fast particles to be created.
When a giant star runs out of fuel, it can no longer support its own weight. It collapses inward, triggering a huge explosion, powerful enough to smash atoms into tiny pieces. The explosion pushes out an expanding cloud of gas and dust, the supernova remnant.